All right. So right now what we're going to do is we're going to look at a retaining wall. Retaining walls are used a lot to keep soils, water, rocks, debris from going to a house when you have a significant slope. So this retaining wall was built. I didn't build it. It was built by another contractor. I just came out to inspect the house to see if the owner is going to buy it or not. So what I noticed right off was I could see it from the top. This retaining wall had a big belly in it, which means it had a curve in it. So that tells me right away there's either movement or it was formed wrong. Well, if you look right here, I don't know if you can see it from back there, but there's a big crack in this wall already. And this wall is only 4 years old. So you got one there, and you got another crack here. So this wall is already failed, and it's not going to stop. Once that pressure is hitting against the wall and it's forcing it in, the more weight you put up here, as you can see right up here, they have this big pile. All this stuff's just creating more weight. All that's going to end up pushing this wall over. It's going to collapse over time. So that's one thing. If you're buying a house or you're looking at buying a house or you have a retaining wall, go look at it. Make sure it's still in good shape because these can collapse. It's a lot of weight behind it, a lot of water. Another thing is you want to make sure that you have drains coming out of the bottom of your retaining wall. Because when you get water behind your retaining wall, that water is going to go down. That water needs to go somewhere so this doesn't end up collapsing. That's when you have drains. You got to have drains coming out through your retaining walls.